When I was asked to share a testimony of God's blessing and God's faithfulness in my life, I right away went back to what happened in 2003, the early part of the year. God was putting ministry in the marketplace on my heart. And I knew job change was coming. I didn't know what, didn't know where, didn't know how. But I knew God was beginning to stir my heart. And in June of that year, Pastor Freitag was preaching to the college and high school graduates. And he was talking to them about going out into the workplace and going out into their vocation and not just seeking a paycheck, but to be seeking God of where they would be placed, that they would be a testimony and a witness for the gospel. And I remember he was preaching out of Habakkuk 2:2-4, which basically says to write down the revelation the Lord has given you today, that a herald may run with it. And though it lingered, a wait for it, it shall not delay, but it shall come to pass. And I remember writing these things in my journal. And God just continued to stir my heart the rest of that year. And then in 2004, April 4th, as a matter of fact, Josh Higgins was here on a Sunday night, and he was basically given the same message about, are you where God wants you to be? Are you being a witness or a testimony out in the workplace? At the end of the service, he called people forward, just had Dave Seeley play music, and he just kind of dismissed the service, but opened the altars for people to come forward and just seek God. As I went forward that night, God just so strong brought that back in my heart about ministry in the marketplace. And 9 days later, April 13th, 2004, I lost my job. I was working for a trucking company, 23 years at that time. I had an accident, and as I sat in my boss's office on the other side of his desk, here I am in my 40s, I'd lost my job. I didn't know anything else. My boss said, I need to let you go, otherwise he's going to let me go, David. And I sat there with a frog in my throat and got my eyes moist. I had picked up a phrase 2 weeks earlier from Dave Herron that God is my provider no matter who signs the check. And as I sat there, my boss said, David, we need to let you go. Those words rang in my head. And after those words, if God is my provider, no matter who signs a check, the Lord asked me a question, David, do you believe these words? As I sat there, I had to answer God, and I said, yes, I do. And I left my boss's office without a job. And as I looked at the situation, it did not seem to be very good timing. We had started a building project in 2002. It was about a three-year project. We're doing it all ourselves. And my son, David, was graduating from high school in June. My daughter, Nicole, was getting married in July. In my eyes, it seemed to be one of the worst times to lose a job. But God had a plan. Over the next few weeks, as I began to seek God about where He would have me work, about where He wanted me to be, He began to open up my heart, begin to show me self-employment, begin to show me areas where my strengths were, areas where I enjoyed working. And as we printed up business cards, I had nowhere to give them to, nowhere to go. But my son David and my wife both went to Jefferson High School. My son went as a student, my wife worked there. And they had been hearing about this building project over the last 2 years. And as many of them came to my son's graduation, a lot of them began to ask, you know, do you do this kind of work on other people's homes? I spent the whole graduation giving tours of the addition that we had built over the last 2 years. And I passed out business cards, and God had me go into self-employment, home repairs and home remodeling from that time on. You know, there's times I've been amazed when I see some of the doors God has opened up. You know, I go in homes to do repairs and remodeling, but many, many times as I'm in a home, somebody's got a doctor's report or someone's lost their job, or they've had a situation in their life where they're just really beginning to question life. And many times God has had me sit at a coffee table or at a kitchen table and just begin to share the gospel. You know, God is faithful. God will open doors for us that we would never imagine. And my challenge to you would be, are there things God has put on your heart? Are you in the vocation? Are you in the place where God would have you be to be a testimony and a witness as to what He's done in your life?
In the nations, awaken.